Good morning. Today we celebrate the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and we have one announcement before we begin. Give the gift of life. We have a blood drive coming up next Saturday from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. Please call the Red Cross to make an appointment to donate or just walk in. Blood is desperately needed, and we will be having another drive in August. Today we remember those who have died on this date. Edward W. Olson, 1974. Martin F. Santulli, 1999. John P. Greco, 2004. Kendall J. Major, 2013. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us now prepare our hearts and minds for prayer.
So quiet. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, with me today is Deacon Steven Lape from St. Joseph's, one of our deacons, and also be addressing us this morning after the gospel. So we expect great things.
Not as good as yours.
No pressure. If you're visiting our community today, we welcome you with great joy. If you haven't been here in a long time, we welcome you home. And we especially welcome some special friends from the great Commonwealth of Virginia and the great state of New Jersey. As we come around the altar of the Lord today, our wonderful gospel is that story that we're all so familiar with, and that Jesus feeds 5,000 people out of nothing. And so he also feeds us and welcomes us to recline at his table here in this church. But before we do so, let's take a moment to look into our hearts, to consider any sins that we may have, seeking God's pardon and God's peace.
Lord Jesus, you came to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are sent to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. I did want to make a special welcome to all our sisters and brothers who are with us by way of the internet, especially our friends from Missouri. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast, even now, to those that endure forever. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baalishisha, bringing to Elisha, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elisha insisted, "Give it to the people to eat. For thus says the Lord, they shall eat, and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, just as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The hand of the Lord. I will bless your name forever, every day. I will bless you, praise your name forever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. One body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Prophet has risen in our midst. God has visited his people.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes, he saw that a large crowd was coming to him. He said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food to feed them so they can eat?" And he said to him, he said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' worth wages of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place, so the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. When Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much as fish as they wanted. When they had their fill, he said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over, so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "Truly, this is a prophet, the one who is to come into the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As Father said, this is probably one of the most richest readings and well-known readings, gospel readings, that people know. The feeding of the 5,000 men. There's probably more because they didn't include the women and children in that number. And it connects well with the first reading as well, with Elisha. And we can look at this reading in a couple of different ways. Either way, there's a huge miracle happening. Feeding of the 5,000 with such few number of bread and fish. A true miracle. Some scholars also say that another miracle is there was plenty of food there, but they didn't share. The miracle was their hearts were opened up, so they shared their food. And I say that because yesterday, at the prison that I work in, we had our communion service. And I couldn't have timed it even better. I put the missiles on all the seats before the guys came in. And of course, the back row, there isn't enough, so there's only one or two back there, missiles. And of course, everyone wants to sit back there. So all of a sudden, someone says, "I don't have a missile. We don't have any back here." So next thing I knew, all these guys started bringing some books back to them, handed them out, and then they stacked up about 10 right next to me. It's like, I could not have planned this even better. Not that I multiply, I divide, but still, they couldn't have planned that better to fit this reading. But there's something else, if we look deep into this reading, that I really want to focus on today. And that's the fragments that were left over. Nothing went to waste. And when we look around, if we take time looking around here today, who are or where are those fragments? Who are the fragments in our community not sitting with us today that we need to make sure we gather up? I think that's a big challenge of today's readings. The fragments in the world, the poor, the LGBT population who don't feel comfortable sitting in these pews, the people with substance use disorders, mental health issues that we look at as being eccentric or odd, but need to be sitting here with us, the people who are divorced and find relationship with someone else. Who are the fragments we need to gather up to look for and to bring into our wicker basket in this building here today? How do we do that? And the how question, I think, is typically the more difficult question to ask. But it includes something very important to all of us: faith. Faith that we have, community-wide, everyone sitting here, we have resources to gather all those fragments to bring them here with us. And we need to trust in God and have faith that He will provide. As it says in the readings today, He will provide for all. One day, a middle-aged woman came into a mist of this poverty and cruelty. She saw the tragic situation and said to herself, "Something's got to be done." She took all the money that she had and rented an old building with a dirt floor. The building wasn't much, but it would do. The next day, the woman went around the neighborhood and offered to teach the children. She used the old building as her classroom. She had no desks, no chairs, no tables. Her chalkboard was the dirt floor. She rubbed it smooth with an old rag and wrote on it with a stick. That was the way the woman fought back against the poverty, the cruelty around her. It was a pathetic response, but it was the best that she could do. Whatever happened to that woman and her undertaking? In 1982, she had 80 fully equipped schools, 300 modern mobile dispensaries, 70 leprosy clinics, 30 homes for the dying, 30 homes for the abandoned children, and 40,000 volunteers worldwide helping her. Of course, we know her today as Saint Mother Teresa. She took all she had, all the resources, just like that boy in the gospel today with the 5 loaves and 2 fishes, gave it all away, and God responded and created and gave back in abundance more
than any could ask for. We can't make excuses for our community. If one person can do that, we as a community can certainly reach out to those fragments, marginalize, and bring them into our wicked, wicked basket.
And together we stand for our profession of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Confident that the Lord provides us with more than enough to satisfy our hunger, let us turn to God with our needs and the needs of the world.
For the church to remain awake and responsive to the hungers of the world, always continuing Jesus' mission of compassion and redemption, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations to work together to find a way to provide food for all so that everyone who hungers is satisfied, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are affected by wildfires, drought, extreme heat, excessive rain and flooding, whose lives and livelihoods are ended or upended by nature, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in fear of never having enough, that the Holy Spirit bring them faith and hope and deep trust in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill in mind, body, or spirit, that the hope of God's call brings healing and peace, and for protection for our military and first responders, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved deceased, especially
Michael Fazio, Fred Wallace, Eleanor McCarran, Steve Novak, Dennis Nowinski, Frank Boscher, Helen Smirstick, Jean Quattro Chioki, Dan Sliva, Rose Rossi, John Greco, and Jack LaValle.
Who we remember at this Eucharist, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers offered from the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Generous God, we know that you are the abundance in our midst, and we bring you our prayers this day. always made in the name of Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours will be found pleasing and acceptable in the sight of God, our Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the morning dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, Howard, our Bishop Emeritus, and all those who serve the Church. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her devoted spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Power and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace.
Peace be with you. My sisters and brothers, behold Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Prayer of Spiritual Communion. I wish my Lord to receive you with the purity, humility, and devotion with which your most holy mother received you. with the spirit and fervor of the saints.
Here in this place.
I'd like to extend our sympathy and our hope to Mary Nally, who is here. She just lost her dad last week, and so we pray for him and pray for all of you and your family as well. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
By the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, thy hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I?
I will go.